The worst fear is always that you're not going to see the people that you love again. Yeah, that's the worst fear. The worst fear is the suffering of other people. That's hard to cope with, probably even more than your own suffering. Yeah, I would definitely say that. Our ability to empathize with each other is quite massive. When somebody else loses a parent, we all feel it. And the same if I was to have any suffering, I'm aware that other islanders, other Pacific people, other Tongans all feel exactly my feeling. That's how close we are. At the moment, we've had no contact at all with anyone from Tonga since before the tsunami had actually hit, since before the volcano had hit, and then everything went dark. I was just basically, like everybody else, really shocked. The imagery in particular was so memorable. Like, it's something that we'll probably be referencing for a long time. And that's a very, very new experience, being from being an Australian who's also from Tonga, because most of the time we're trying to explain to people where Tonga is. So it's a really strange thing to jump on the internet, for example, and not have contact with our family that we've been, you know, we've usually in contact all the time, especially through Messenger. Like, these days we're in a lot more contact than we used to be, just on a daily basis. And so suddenly having this awareness that satellites are looking at our part, our neck of the woods, you know, our ocean, and seeing Tonga represented in that way, and with just the magnificence of, you know, just, it's so, you get struck with awe. Really quite a, almost a disembodying feeling. Everybody who has people in Tonga is dealing with this. And so a lot of the time, you know, it's not a usual thing to just care about yourself. Like, caring about yourself is also caring about, you know, the next 10 people, then 20 people, then 100 people. And then it's like, oh, I must contact these people. And that really does ricochet all the way throughout the Pacific.